Hi, I'm David Domoney, and I'm a proud patron of Greenfingers charity. Now, we all know that engaging with plants and nature in our gardens has a positive impact on our physical and mental well-being. And during lockdown, the whole of the nation realised that as we got outside and got close to plants and nature in our own garden and helping us get through those very difficult times. Greenfingers have realised the positive power of plants and gardens for the last two decades and have installed over 60 gardens in children's hospices all over the nation. Now, all of Greenfingers' gardens are unique and they're beautiful as well. But it's not just about beauty, they have a themed purpose as well. Some of them are just for fun, some of them are for therapy, and others, like this one here in Loughborough at Rainbow's Children's Hospice, this is for reflections and remembrance. This is where whole families can come together and remember a brother or sister who has sadly died. David Hamilton, the psychological and bereavement lead at Rainbow's Hospice, told me why this garden is such a special place.
Hospices are about how do we live well, and also how do we die well. And having gardens for children to explore, to move around in, to connect to touch, to taste, to smell, that's really important.
It's a garden where parents place plaques, wind chimes, and even plants like trees or shrubs in memory of their child who's died.
There's always new life in gardens. There's new hope and new possibilities. And there's always a future in a garden. And that's really important for families when sometimes the future feels really scary.
Children's hospices can be incredibly uplifting places. They can be places that really help sick children and young people, along with their family, get through very difficult times.
Children, brothers and sisters, don't stop becoming brothers and sisters and children just because their brother or sister is dying. And having space to be creative, to play, to laugh, to weep, to explore is really important, and having garden spaces around the hospice building allows that to happen, and that's really important.
But the sad reality is that, like other hospices, Rainbow's also provides end-of-life care for children and young people coming to the end of their hospice journey. It's the saddest journey any of us could imagine. In 2019, after a short illness, June's daughter Jodie passed away at the hospice. Jodie was only 19 when she died.
For Jodie, nothing could take away the fact, the cancer and the fact that she was dying. So it's about thinking and looking at other things. And when we came to Rainbow's, she just absolutely fell in love with the place. It wasn't necessarily about her being poorly or about her dying. It was about her living. Every moment is precious. Let's do something with that moment. Let's do something with that day, rather than concentrate on that. That's why this place is just so beautiful, really. I think a lot of people that have lost children feel like me, and they don't just come here to remember the ones that they've lost. They'll come here and remember all of those children.
And gardens like this one can provide that vital space for those moments when peaceful solace is needed. Greenfingers still has a big waiting list from hospices that need gardens for children, and because of the pandemic, that list has become even longer. But to continue to give the gift of gardens to these hospices, we need your help. It's important to Greenfingers, it's important to the staff at the hospices, and it's important to the families as well. Now, whether you're a business, whether you're a community, or whether you're an individual, you can help simply by giving a £10 donation by texting the number 700 85. Thank you for giving, thank you for caring, and thank you for helping us make a difference to children like Jodie and her family. For more information, please follow the link.